All right, everyone, Marriland here, and I just wanted to show you something before I headed to Dragonspiral Tower and changed my clock back to normal, because there's one other thing I wanted to confirm. Yes, if you go back after beating the Shadow Triad, if you go back at a different season, you'll be able to battle them again until your heart's content. So, yeah, feel free to do that. You only need to fight one. If you decide to wimp out, you can always fight them again later. Yeah, but I just thought I would show you that really quick, just because that was something I wanted to test out in the last episode, but I kind of forgot. Alright, so now we're gonna go on over to Dragonspiral Tower, but only after it is, actually, you know what? Since you might not have been watching the last episode, in order to get to this place up here, there's a Nevermelt Ice pack back there. I just don't want to... Well, actually, I've already gotten it. I just don't want to walk through the grass for no reason. That's how you get up to this thick grass. It has to be winter time, okay? You're not going to see that if you're playing in any other season. So, I'm going to go in this house really quick here. I'm going to save, and I'm going to change my clock back to October, like it should be. So, I will see you in a moment. Alright, as you can see, yeah, doing a bit of time traveling here, but now things are back to what they were. I just wanted to show you what happens in winter, because otherwise, you know, you might not know, or you might be watching while it's winter and be wondering, wow, what's up with all this snow, man? So, yeah, now we're back on track. It's summer, even though it's October, which is bizarre, if you ask me, but whatever. So, let's head on over to Dragonspiral Tower! Now, in order to get there, you have to go through this little area first. This is the, this is actually the exterior of Dragonspiral Tower. And you can find some Pokemon in here. Not sure. Oh, yeah, look at that. You can find Drudigan. Level 58. Oh, my goodness. You can find them at even higher of a level if you go up to the thick grass. But again, that's only in the winter time, so, you know, don't get too excited. I think you can find slightly different Pokemon here than inside, but don't quote me on that. As you go in, you'll run into Cedric. We still don't know anything about it. Could the Dragonspiral Tower somehow symbolize ideals? Could it somehow represent truth? So you came here as well. It was 2 years ago. In this tower, a certain man and a certain Pokemon came face to face. This man sought the truth so he could change the world. That's right, this building rising serenely into the sky is the Dragonspiral Tower. It has towered over this land since before Unova was founded. Well, wait, then who built it? On the highest floor, the legendary Dragon-type Pokemon was waiting for the appearance of a person seeking the truth. It was exactly how the legend said it would be. Ah, the Lightstone! If that's the case, you must be headed to the top floor, changing the world. That's an outrageous idea, but it is possible to change yourself, as long as you seek the truth. My, that conversation sure took a serious turn. Maybe something light and sweet would help balance things out. Devin obtained an old gâteau. Ah, gee, thanks, pal. You really shouldn't have. Be seeing you. Yum, old gâteau. Now, before you head on inside, you can actually surf across the water really quick here, and you can find some stuff. There's a big old patch of thick grass here, and... Oops, there's some rustling grass, darn it. Yeah, and there's just some normal grass here. It doesn't look like there's any hidden items. That's a shame. Now, one thing you can do, in the, rustling grass, you can find a Vanilluxe. Very rarely, only 5% of the time. But if you think that's rare, just try to find a Dragonite. If you use the Super Rod here, you'll find yourself a Dratini about 60% of the time. Dragonair 9%, but if you're really lucky, you can find a Dragonite here 1% of the time with a Super Rod. I'm just going to show you really quick. I'm obviously not going to get that Dragonite. But just to get an idea, oh wait, I don't have the Super Rod, that's right. I have to talk to Cedric in, oh, where is it? Nuvama Town in order to get it. That's where you get the Super Rod, by the way. Yeah, so no magical Dratini adventure today. Oh well, no big deal. Just thought I'd point that out, because that's pretty cool to find something so rare. Now, time to head inside the tower. Time to head inside the tower. Now, again, you're not really going to be able to do any good here unless you have already gone to N's castle at the back of Victory Road. If you haven't done that, and if you haven't fought N and beat him, then you won't have the Lightstone, and you won't be able to do much of anything here. You can still climb up to the top, I think, but you're not going to be able to trigger any scenes. In here, you can find Go Lurk, level 55. You can also find, well, I'll see if I can show you. None of the Pokemon in here are overly rare, so that's good. You can only find three different varieties. Golurk is definitely the most common of the bunch. 50% of the time, you can find, well, that's what you can find Golurk with. Dredigon, you can find 30%. And, you know, you can find it outside, too, so it's no big deal. And then there's one more Pokemon. Let's see if we can find it. It's a 20% encounter rate, so that's not that bad. So in here, if you have strength, you should definitely push this boulder into that hole. If you don't, it's okay. You don't need it. It's just a nice shortcut. If you don't have it, you can go up and around here. You can pick up a hidden red shard inside of that rock there. And don't forget this elixir underneath that fallen pillar thing. It's a marble column. Let's see. More Golurk. I don't even know. Not what I want to see. Let's just leave it at that. There's just one Pokemon left that I want to see. Alright, so see, you can climb across this thing and you can get over there. Cool. So, get myself an Ultra Ball. Just kind of chilling there. So, up here, there's an interesting little room. It should be reminiscent of some kind of tower in Heart Gold and Soul Silver. You can jump across these things. Now, if you want to get all the items, just hop across this middle one first. The bottom one will take you to where you need to go, but you're going to miss out on this shiny stone! I know, another shiny stone. Jump across here, and then you can pick up a protein on your way back to the start. Always good to have some extra protein. And then just ignore this top one. You can probably even see it's just, oop, darn it. I was just trying to face that direction. Oh, well, I'll show you a live example. Yeah, pretty dumb, huh? There we go. So just hop on across and you'll be able to climb up the stairs. What do we have up the stairs? I want to fight a big old dragon. I don't see any big old dragon here. No Disco Inferno. Burn, baby, burn, like the originals. Oh, so in this room here, you can find three items here, and they're pretty cool. You can find the Lustrous Orb. You can find the Grigious Orb. And you can find the Adamant Orb. Now, these items power up the power of Dialga, Palkia, and Giratina's attacks, respectively, or something like that. I got the order wrong. You can't get them in Black 2 and White 2 on their own, though, so don't get too excited. You'll have to migrate them from a previous version, one of the Generation 4 versions. Or you can find them, apparently, in the Pokemon Dream Radar. Now, I'm not going to cover that. I don't have anything that can record from that. So, but I'll just tell you, they're there, and that is a way you can get them. So, this is the Cylinder Room, as I like to call it. Do not bother going over to the west there. It's just a waste of your time. Instead, head on over to the east, cross the bridge, and then, oh, actually, hold up. That's the way I want to go. You see, you could totally miss out. Or wait, maybe it isn't. I don't know. Well, I'm going to pick this item up here. You probably don't need me to tell you exactly how. You can watch and learn. There's a PP Max over here. Very good to have. What did that ramp take me over to? Oh, it's just another way to get there, I guess. Very useful. TM2, Dragon Claw. It's a strong Dragon-type attack. It's not, like, super strong, but 80 power is pretty good. And a lot of non-Dragon Pokemon can learn it. I don't think I have anyone that can, but let's just see. Nope, no one can. Oh, well, big deal. Okay, so in the middle ring here, gonna have to hop down that thing. and then just kind of walk on over. And before you head over to those stairs, make sure you pick up the Max Revive. Always good to have those, particularly with so many difficult fights in the game. Well, you know, the tough trainers. You can use that ledge to go back to the beginning, should you so desire, but I want to climb these stairs up instead. Up here, you'll find another floor. There's a Comet Shard here, which is excellent, because this thing can be sold for a fortune. I know, it's insane how much you can sell it for. You can sell it for 60,000 Pokédollars if you take it to the guy in Isaris City. You know, the aura guy, the aura he will adore. So, hold up here. Do you see this place? Does this look familiar at all? Oh, man. Well, assuming you have the Light Stone or the Dark Stone if you're playing Pokemon Black 2, when you go up here, you'll run into a certain something. Let's check it out. What do you say? Oh, you gotta walk right in the middle there. The Light Stone. It's trembling inside the bag. Take the Light Stone out of the bag. Are you ready for this? It's gonna be a pretty cool cutscene, so let's take a look. Uh-oh. Now, you don't have to save right before this, don't worry. Unless you want to see the cutscene again, that's the only reason you'd need to. The Light Stone draws in the aura of the surroundings and converts it into a powerful force, which is now being released! Very cool. It's basically the same scene as in the original Black and White, except it takes place in Dragonspiral Tower now. So that's pretty cool. Now before fighting it, you will probably want to save, but you can also go over here and pick up another Comet Shard! I know you're gonna be rich! Rich! Rich with real cash monies. So I'm going to go ahead and save really quick here. Definitely recommend you do the same. Thankfully, either Reshiram or Zekrom, they're not very difficult to catch. In fact, they have a very high catch rate. You're just as likely to catch an Eevee. Now, that's not to say, you know, you throw one Pokeball and you catch it, but it actually can happen. Let's fight this thing. Pira! Alright, Reshiram. Time to catch you. Sweet. Now, it's at level 70, just like it was on N's team, except now it's a wild Pokemon, so you can catch it. N has fully released it. Whatever you do, do not use your Master Ball on it. It's so easy to catch. Oh my goodness. I'm going to toss a Quick Ball. You can oftentimes do this, and it's just pretty effective. It won't always work, but so often you can catch it in one Quick Ball without even putting up a fight or anything. It's very strong still at level 70, and since you can't just use Tyranitar like you could before, due to its massive, Sandstream, it could normally take this thing out, but that Sandstream just hurts. It just makes it so much more difficult to catch. Uh-oh, this is cutting it close! Whoa. No! Ah! What? Oh, man. Really? Really? Critical hits, why do you always do this to me? I think I did this in the first playthrough in my Black 2 Japanese. You showed Reshiram the strength of your Pokemon. I have something to tell you. Don't you ever do that again! No, go to the giant chasm. Kiram has returned. That's what my friend has told me. Yeah, Devin, the world that you desire for Pokemon and humans, I look forward to seeing how full of love that world is. No. Someday, Pokemon and humans will be bound together without Pokeballs. They will simply trust and help one another make that kind of world. Oh no, so because I knocked it out, in order for it to reappear, you have to beat the Elite Four and the Champion again. However, because you've already beaten them, their levels are going to be like middle 70s. So that's why I recommend saving beforehand, because there's no way my Pokemon are going to be able to take them out right now. However, if you already have both Reshiram and Zekrom and you just want to get the DNA splicers, now's a good time. I mean, it doesn't matter if you catch this one. You can go back after taking out Reshiram, back to the giant chasm, and you'll find Kyurem there, along with the giants, or the giant splicers. No, the DNA splicers after you've beaten it. So I'm going to reset really quick, and we're going to try this again, darn it. We're going to try this again. I will be right back. Okay, I'm back, and we're going to try this one more time, alright? Get over here, you little fiend. Man, can't believe I got a critical hit on, like, the first hit. That's so dumb. Okay, America, you really proved your strength there. Alright, let's take this thing out. Let's weaken it with return. Imprison. Oh, that's fine by me. I love it when he uses Imprison. Unless you're trying to use Dragon Pulse or something. Okay, that's better. How on earth did I critical hit and knock it out? Oy. Alright, now we're gonna toss a normal Pokeball at it. Just to show you how easy this thing is to catch. Well, it did have one shake at least. I mean, it's not like super duper duper easy, but it's, you know, really darn easy compared to legendary Pokemon. I know, I'll stop. It would look really cool to have it in a Premier Ball, though, I have to say. Hey, look at me! I'm so awesome! I caught this thing in two Pokeballs! Oh, wow! I should really brag about it like everyone else does on videos. No, I'm just kidding. It's nothing worth bragging about, trust me. So, cool, I caught myself a Reshiram, and let's see what N has to say for himself now. Reshiram has recognized you as the new hero. That's right, as a trainer with a will strong enough to change the world, I have something to tell you. Go to the giant chasm, Kyurem has returned. That's what my friend has told me. Devin, yeah, he says this whole lovey-dovey thing again. Nah, let's see, so, I think after fighting Reshiram here, regardless of if you capture it or if you knock it out, I think then you can return to the Nimbasa City Ferris wheel and you can run into N there. I think so. Oh, really quick, because escape ropes don't work up here, you are able to use Fly, believe it or not. Yep, you are actually not inside of the tower, you're at the top of the tower. So, I am, actually, my next destination really needs to be that giant chasm, but really quick, I just want to take a look in Nimbasa City. I'm not actually going to start this event, but after doing all of this, you can go to the Ferris wheel and run into N there. I don't know which days it is. It might not be today, but I do know you can run into him there, and after you've ridden the Ferris wheel with him, he will show up in the, oh, let's see. Oh, it's Hugh. Maybe you have to go through Hugh first, or like some of your other peeps. But when you do see N there, you can, after riding the Ferris wheel with him, he will show up at N's castle again. And you can fight him, and he's really hard. He uses different teams depending on which season it is, and you can fight him once per season. So I just thought I would throw that out there, just so you knew. Alright, I'm gonna head to Lacanosa Town because the next place on our list of places to go is the Giant Chasm once more. So I'm going to fly back there, and I am going to go ahead and put Reshiram on my team because it is a good Pokemon to use against Kyurem, which I'm going to have to fight in the next episode of Marriland's Pokemon White 2 Adventure. I'll see you next time, trainers.